Thai country.
How are you?
Good, and you?
Happy to meet you today.
Okay.
So what are the research for?
I'm going towards Togo.
And your name?
Okay. Norali. Yeah.
Give me money. Money. Money.
Money.
Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today, it's very sad. I'm not happy because of what has happened. This could have happened to anybody, that's any policeman, because we cannot say that in Africa the police, they are not corrupt. Maybe some few countries they are not corrupt, but other police in other countries, or especially West Africa, we know, let me say Ghana, Nigeria, we know the police.
Thai country.
How are you?
Good, and you?
Happy to meet you today.
Okay.
So what are the research for?
I'm going towards Togo.
And your name?
Okay. Norali. Yes.
Like I take your number, then we'll be communicating.
No. No, no, it's okay. No, no.
Oh, is it for security reasons? Carry on.
Okay. The number.
Give me money. Money. Money.
Money. What? How are you?
Hello.
Hello.
How is everything?
Everything is fine.
From where?
Netherlands.
Yeah?
Netherlands.
Now you the car? What do you bring car? See the that? Eh? Oh, you see the radio. Where they go?
Abuja.
Abuja? No.
How are you?
Give me something.
How is for everything?
Me. Everything is fine.
How's family?
Huh?
How's family?
Good.
Family is good.
This water.
Yeah. Give me money.
Yeah, what till you bring? Wait till you bring come.
Huh?
Wait till you bring come. I say, wait till you bring come.
Wait till you won't give me. Hey, wait till now. Wait till you won't give me. Oh, yeah, give me something. Oh, yeah, give me something. Huh? Give me something.
You give me something.
Yeah. Give me money. Money. Money.
Money. Why?
You understand? It's very unfortunate. When this story came out, I never said anything about it or even made a video about it. But these guys or these policemen being sacked.
Distinguished officers, gentlemen of the press, there was an incident on 23rd of October at between Isenyi and Oyo Road. A tourist from Netherlands was passing to Abuja, and the two police special constabularies before you, other whoever's command, I don't know, went there and they were demanding for money. The Commissioner of Police, Oyo State Command, that is me, I have reviewed the only room conducted for them, because our normal procedure is they should be tried in the room on oath and appropriate punishment meted out to them. I have now reviewed the only room trial of the reporters who are Special Constabulary Karim Fatai and Special Constabulary Stephen Lukman, who were captured on violent video dated 29/10/2023, demanding money from a Netherlands tourist, Ms. Norali Shrivi Adebola A. Hamza, the Commissioner of Police and Oyo State Police Command. Today, Thursday, 21st December 2023, I affirm the recommended punishment of dismissal for the two police Special Constabulary Karim Fatai and Special Constabulary Jiman Lukman, and I hereby pronounce both of them dismissed from the police special constabulary. They will be indicated and seized to the members of the special constabulary with immediate effect. It is hoped that this will serve as a deterrent to others who want to have a similar demand. They should be defeated.
I'm sad. I'm sad because you just look at it on the surface that they asked for money. They didn't even get the money. But at the end of the day, they have been sacked. You know, when this particular video was posted, I think the actual person that did the video posted it on her YouTube channel, and the video actually has a lot of views. Itchy Boat, that's her YouTube channel, and had a lot of views, or has a lot of views, and it's still growing, you understand? Because, you know, people love negative news. But where it actually got escalated was when a guy on TikTok picked that video, that part of that video of the Nigerian policeman asking for money, and the Ghana policeman also saying that he wants the number of the white lady, and merged it together. We all know Ghana-Nigeria stuff, just when they hit the internet, it's just crazy. People just love to see Ghana-Nigeria. I don't know why, but people just love to see that. And this video went viral on TikTok, and that is when all these things started. People started arguing and talking about Ghana police and Nigerian police and all that. It's sad. Right now, the two police officers that were involved in the Nigerian video have been sacked. They have been sacked. It's sad. For me, I am thinking about what their family they are going to eat. Because this is like their livelihood, and I have a lot of Nigerian friends, trust me. And talking to them, clearly the police in Nigeria are not even paid well, you understand? They are not even paid well or even treated well. So going through this and they being stripped of their job, the question is, what are they going to even eat? What are they going to do? You understand? We have deprived a lot of people. Like, that's a whole family. Because imagine these two police people or policemen are taking care of a wife, children, and perhaps extended families. We don't know. And I came here to say this because I'm very sad about this. Nobody should be happy when another man goes down. What they did wasn't right when it comes to the rules and regulations of the police, but it's not something to joke about. It is very sad. I hope they will find something to do and be able to take care of their families. It's sad, bro. It's sad. What they did, I'm not saying what they did is not wrong. Yes, it is wrong. But we all know in Ghana too, we have police. We've heard a lot of stories in Ghana, police people being corrupt and all that. So please, it is not something that you will say is just a Nigerian police that is, or that are corrupt. No, when you watch the Nigerian video, you could see that there were other policemen that the lady met on her way, but these people did not even do what ask for money. It is only these police people two police people or personnel that actually asked for money.
Welcome to, I don't even know the name of the stone. So I asked in the guest house yesterday how the condition of this road was, and they were like, it's really good. I can't really say that I agree. Oh man. Oh, oi, oi. Careful. Oh, they have to go over this little wooden. It's gonna stop me. Yeah.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
How the journey?
Good.
What do I know? From where?
Netherlands.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay. Continue, I go. Eh? Thank you. Yeah. Just keep going. It's again like every kilometer there's a place like this. Every kilometer.
Welcome.
How are you?
Fine. How's the journey?
Good.
To where?
Abuja.
Abuja?
Yeah.
Good journey.
Thank you. How are you?
Hello.
Hello.
How is everything?
Everything is fine.
From where?
Netherlands.
What do you bring up? See the that? Eh? Oh, you see the radio. Where they go?
Abuja. How are you?
Give me something.
How is for everything?
Everything is fine.
Give me something. Oh yeah, give me something. Give me something.
You give me something.
Give me money. Money. Money.
Money. Why?
Give me.
Why?
Okay.
Okay, bye bye. Give me money. No. No idea why this line is here. Oh, I see now, this truck, it came off the road. Mein Himmel. Hi. How are you?
White woman.
A white woman.
How are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
Are you enjoying my company?
I am. Thank you. Okay. A white woman. Yes.
So in Ghana, seeing that policeman not asking for money, I understand. But she could have gotten to another place that those police people could have also asked for money. So no one is like very corrupt and the other is not corrupt. We know in Africa, we know the level of corruption, we know the people who are corrupt. Yes. I'm sad, to be honest. I'm sad. Because that was what actually was ringing in my head. That what are they going to depend on? What are they going to do? It's just sad. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching the video. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.